Hi, this demo will show you how to start building bots and digital workers for BotStore in 3 easy steps. BotStore offers the largest opportunity to build a recurring revenue stream and expand globally through the most comprehensive RPA platform. You can start building bots and digital workers for BotStore in 3 easy steps. Step 1. Request for a Getting Started Kit by filling out a form and get everything you need to get started. Step 2. Build your bot or digital worker with a license management and code protection. Step 3. Incorporate best practice guidelines and follow the step-by-step submission process to publish your bot or digital worker on BotStore. Let's start with the first step. Request your Getting Started Kit. Go to the link mentioned on the screen to request the Getting Started Kit. You will soon receive an email from BotStore with the Getting Started Kit, an invite-only repository that includes the instructions for license management and code protection, best practices for your BotStore listing, best practices for building reusable bots and digital workers, code examples, copy of a licensed DLL which needs to be integrated into your MetaBots, and a sample bot package with the required folder structure for the bot or digital worker you are building. Now let's show you how to do it. Go to the link mentioned and fill out the form to tell us about the bot or digital worker you want to build. Submit the form to request the Getting Started Kit. You will soon receive an email from BotStore with the Getting Started Kit that includes everything you need to build your bot or digital worker. Here's an example of a sample bots package that helps us understand the correct folder structure required to properly package the bot or digital worker. You will also find best practice guidelines in this repository to ensure you are building your bot or digital worker correctly. You have completed step 1 by receiving the Getting Started Kit for your bot or digital worker. The next step is to build your bot or digital worker using Automation Anywhere Enterprise Client, version 11.3.3 and above. License management can be incorporated in 2 ways. First, by integrating a pre-built license management MetaBot utility with a completely UI-based bot. Or second, by modifying the existing DLL to integrate the reference license DLL. Code protection can be applied to both TaskBots and MetaBots. You can also generate a zipped bot package with all the dependent files directly from the Automation Anywhere Enterprise client. Now let's show you how to do it. The easiest way to incorporate license management is to use the sample code snippets provided in the Getting Started Kit. In this example, we are modifying the existing DLL to integrate the reference license DLL. Right-click on the existing DLL and add reference for the license DLL. Follow the documentation provided and the license validator DLL. This refers the license DLL to the existing DLL. Copy-paste the code snippet from the documentation under Step 2, calling license DLL with your existing code. Remember to replace the global ID, which is highlighted on the screen, to the one provided to you in the email sent by the BotStore. Use this code as the first part of your class. Next, call the function that you have just created in the method you are trying to expose as a logic in the MetaBot to validate the license. In this example, the bot's purpose is to post a Slack message to a Slack channel. Take the function name and search for the method that posts the message to the Slack channel. Here, we can see that the post message is the method name, and as part of the first method, we are adding the check license function. Save your code and build the solution. This will validate the license. Now we need to create a MetaBot and add all the dependent DLLs to the assets section. Then simply create or edit the logic to add the access code variable. This will enable the access code to be taken as an input parameter from the MetaBot file. Find the access code variable in the MetaBot's variable manager. Edit it to add input in the parameter type field. The same thing needs to be done for the TaskBot. An easy way to do this is to add the MetaBot logic to the TaskBot. The access code variable also needs to be defined in the TaskBot's variable manager so that a user can pass the access code as an input parameter and the value is then passed on to the MetaBot. Lastly, ensure that all the dependent files are added to the bot dependencies to enable code protection. Once all these steps are completed, right-click on the task bot and create zip to create a zipped package directly from the Automation Anywhere Enterprise client. Review the zipped package to ensure that all files have been generated correctly. You have completed step 2 and successfully built and packaged your bot or digital worker. The third and final step is to submit your bot or digital worker to BotStore in order to publish them. Log into BotStore and go to the My Submissions page. Add new bot and follow the step-by-step submission process to submit your bot or digital worker. Review the best practice guidelines to make sure your bot or digital worker passes our review process. Once you submit your bot or digital worker, BotStore sends you a confirmation email and reviews your submission. If your bot or digital worker fails the review process, BotStore sends you an email with the list of corrections to be made. Resubmit your bot with the necessary modifications to continue the review process. Once the review is completed successfully, your bot or digital worker is published on the BotStore. Now let's show you how to do it. Go to the BotStore and log in if you are not already logged in. Navigate to the My Submissions page and click on the Add New Bot to open the submission page. Here, you can view more documentation on best practice guidelines to ensure that your bot or digital worker has been built and packaged correctly. Follow the step-by-step submission process. Review the best practice guidelines for each step to successfully pass your bot or digital worker through the submission review process. The information you provide on the submission form will be published on BotStore and will be visible to the public. Add information that will be useful to those who are interested in your bot or digital worker. Make sure to add screenshots and a demo video. Vendors are required to provide support for all paid bots and digital workers. Please input the correct point of contact for support requests. Once your bot or digital worker has been reviewed and approved, it will be published by the BotStore with its own bot listing page. Here's how the page will look once it's published. You have now completed step 3 and are ready to start building bots and digital workers for BotStore. Want to build your business on BotStore? Get started by requesting your Getting Started kit.